Just the other day, a meme made it to the front page of Reddit, which originated in the math memes subreddit. This is the meme. It's a variation on the Drake format meme, where the thing at the top is what you don't want, you're shunning that. The thing at the bottom is the better version you do want. And in this case, we're looking at values of the sine function for different angles. I will say, I'm aware that memes, particularly one like this that's been around for a couple years now, can evolve into a more ironic sense. And occasionally this is used to show that the bottom one looks superficially better, but actually isn't. However, I'm pretty sure this was posted in earnest, given the title of the post was, "Isn't it awesome? Way to learn the values, to be honest." And the whole thing was like organic marketing for a private tutoring firm, particularly if you look through the comments that the original poster was putting below. I think they were genuinely trying to say, this is a better way to write the values of a sine function. And surely it is. It's got a really nice pattern in it. If you look at the sine values for 0 degrees, 30, 45, 60, and 90, and you write them the traditional way, the values seem to have nothing to do with each other. But if you rearrange them all, you get this fantastic sequence that goes from the square root of 0 on 2 all the way up to the square root of 4 on 2. And that, obviously, that's what mathematicians love. That kind of unexpected pattern just hiding in plain sight, and suddenly you see it. So I took this meme and I shared it in a private WhatsApp group for mathematics communicators, and they hated it. Oh, almost universal, a massive wave of dislike and disdain, if I may, for this meme. And the reason they all got so emotional is that the pattern in this meme doesn't exist. Yeah, it's not real. The major red flag that something is amiss here is that a lot of this is not in simplified form. Not only that, it's in arbitrary form. I mean, who writes 0 as the square root of 0 divided by 2? I mean, you can have all sorts of crazy equations, put a 0 in there, the whole thing equals 0. It doesn't give us any additional insight into the notion of 0, that you can take its square root and divide it by 2 and it's still 0. And likewise, 1. Who writes 1 as the square root of 4 divided by 2? I mean, it's the square root of a thing divided by the square root of the thing. Again, you can write loads of equations and divide them by the same thing and get 1. What are we learning? And then, my poor sine of 30. I mean, a lot of this could be justified if, by putting it in a more complicated form, we were able to see some kind of interesting pattern. Get to that in a moment. But now, we're just hiding otherwise interesting values. I love sine 30. Sine 30 equals 1/2. It's so good. And yet, it's now sine of 30 equals the square root of 1 divided by 2. I mean, why would you do that to sine 30? You know what? Let me show you why the sine of 30 degrees is so amazing using this Geogebra file made by Ben Sparks. Link below. So I'm going to turn on the sine value, which, just to recap, as I move this dot around the circle, the sine value is just how far above the axis it is. So here we're slightly above the axis, and so the sine value is currently 0.18. And as I move this all the way around, it goes all the way up until it's 1. It's a height of 1 above the axis. And when I get to 30 degrees, which is about there, so it's like a third of the way, give or take, around that quarter, you can see it hits 1/2. And I love that. A third of a quarter is 1/2. Oh, it's so good. And then by the time we go, like, so we're halfway across, or 2/3 up, that all lines up again because of symmetry, and then you get the point over here. And so the whole nature of sine and angles and circles, once you hit 90 degrees, your quarter turn, it's 1, because it's the top of the circle, and when it's 0, it's 0, and it's such a shame to have lost that with the way they do it. And here you're getting way more detail. So you can see initially, the plot is pretty much a straight line. And then by the time you get up to the top here, then it starts to curl out. And these are all the bits that we've got in the original meme. But why stop there? I mean, it's like you've come in partway through the straight line, and then it's just starting to get interesting. You go, we need to go all the way around. Look at that. back down. Now we get the full symmetry of back down to zero. And then the same thing repeats, but it's flipped. Everything's now negative because we're a negative amount above the axis. We're below the axis, so I can fill in the rest of the sine wave. Missed a bit. Let's get that bit over there. And then back. And so this, for me, this is the real beauty of the sine function. These cool values. And the nice, and it makes sense looking at it geometrically, why a third gives you a half and all these things. So good. But yet, they've all been lost. We better get some pretty amazing insights into the patterns behind the values coming out of a sine function to justify this reckless obfuscating of the true values we all know and love. And sadly, we don't. This sequence is ridiculous. For a start, you've got random jumps between the values. We go from 0 to 30, and then we only go up 15 to 45, and then 60 and 90. What is up with that? And there's no nice pattern between the results. I mean, it looks like it, but there isn't. They're not multiples of each other. You're not adding the same amount each time. They look visually similar, but there's no, I mean, because of the square root, that pesky square root, because of it, there is no nice sequence between each of these terms. That's not the pattern we care about though, is it? We don't care about the square root or the divide by two. It's just the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the visually pleasing pattern why this image gets shared. So I thought, well, let's move away the rest of the stuff we don't need. Instead of having the sine of some angle equals the square root of some number n divided by 2, we'll move the 2 to the other side, we'll square both sides, and 4 times sine squared of theta, that's what gives us the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 sequence from the original image for the angles that they picked. But why just those angles? Let's plot all of them. So I did. I've gone from 0 to 90 degrees, and those horizontal lines are the whole, like the integer values going up to 4, because now we're multiplying it by 4. So instead of 1, we go up to 4. And any continuous function that went from 0 to 4 is going to go through 1, 2, and 3 in between. And we can just pick those points, and there's your meme. And as you can see, the line does different things in between. There's nothing interesting about those points other than they're just where it happens to be a whole value. And you could argue, you're right, they do happen at some slightly interesting points, but that was more obvious in the original top version. I will concede one point though, it's nice and symmetric, which we didn't have before. Before we were looking at a quarter of the total wave, started straight and then flattened out. Whereas now, because we've got the square of a sine wave, which is just another sine wave, because the square of the sine of an angle equals 1 minus cos twice the angle divided by 2, and that's regular cos, not squared, that's a sine wave. Sine squared is a sine, but because it's squashed in, we now have half a cycle. We go from the bottom curvy bit all the way up to the top curvy bit. Technical way of describing that, which is half of the wavelength, perfectly symmetric. The straight bit is now in the middle, and that's why when we had one of those integer lines crossing right in the middle, the other two are the same distance in each direction. So one's 15 degrees one way, like a third of the rest of it, and one's 15 degrees the other way. So even though they're not nicely spaced, you've got 0 and 90, you've got the middle one, and because of the symmetry, the other ones are the same distance in. I mean, it's something. So I take back some of what I was saying about the square root. All of that said, the square roots and the symmetry is not enough to save this meme. It's both a bad mathematical pattern, because it doesn't actually exist, and it's a bad way to learn those values. Even in the WhatsApp group with the other maths communicators, when I shared it, someone put in this way of learning the same values the same way, where you pick the finger that corresponds to the angle, and the square root of the number of fingers above and below give you sine and cos and tan. That's a superior way to do this, if all you want is an opaque, terrible mnemonic with no insight into what's actually going on. But I want some insight, and so I asked around on that WhatsApp group what people think the bottom bit of that meme should be. If it's just, what's the thing which is better than what is at the top? What is the version of the top that we want to embrace? And here is what I got. The first response I got was from Katie Steckles, who just said the angles should be radians. So there we are. That's a lot better. Mathematicians love radians, partly because yes, you do see some extra patterns, but largely it's just a purer, more fundamental way to measure the size of an angle. And actually we can see another pattern now. We've got pi on 2, pi on 3, pi on 4, then no pi on 5, then pi on 6. Why did the original meme maker take out pi on 5, or 36 degrees as we know it? And you can contort that into the square root of a thing over 2, except it's 5 minus root 5 on 2. That's what happens if you go away from their very carefully selected specific examples. Up next, Ben Sparks drew this, which is pretty good. He did say he was a bit rushed, and when I spoke to him, I was asking everyone if I could use their submissions, he said he wanted to add a circle, and given we were using his Geobebra file earlier, fine, we'll put in the proper version. And that's really nice, because now you can see the logic behind where these values come from, and how the structure and shape of the wave and a circle change what the values are, and how they interact with each other. So I think that's really nice. And finally, Becky Warren sent in two triangles. And this is my personal favorite. In fact, this is how I remember what these values are. And if you have to teach these values, just, you know, if someone has to learn them, this is the one I recommend, because not only is it easy to remember, you just got to sketch those two triangles, which to this day I still do, but it's not just some arbitrary pattern, that's a really nice bit of logic, and it shows you how Pythagoras links to these values. And we've got our root 2 and our root 3, the main roots, on display. And so that's why I think this is the ultimate version of this ridiculous meme. Well, thanks so much for watching the video. We really appreciate it. If you're new here, do subscribe to the channel. I want you to do that. That's a good thing over here. They'll be hugely appreciated. And not all the videos are ridiculous over-analysis of memes. That's a good point. All the videos are ridiculous in their own separate special ways. So do make sure you check out this video over here. This is also pretty good.